Welcome to Wingate series of video tutorials. In this video, I am going to show how to determine the number of peaks for a given molecule in NMR spectra. The number of peaks observed in NMR spectra indicates the number of nuclei with a different magnetic environment. The magnetic environment indicates, first of all, linkage. In the example, the two types of protons are present. One is the primary protons and another one is secondary protons. Similarly, another aspect for magnetic environment is configuration. So here you can observe one of the proton is cis to chlorine and another proton is trans to chlorine. So these type of nuclei are called as magnetically non-equivalent nuclei, and each magnetically non-equivalent nuclei yields an NMR signal. So what are the steps to identify the number of peaks for a given molecule? First, identify magnetically non-equivalent nuclei in the given molecule. Label all the nuclei with alphabetical letters like A, B and C. And finally, count the number of the non-equivalent nuclei, which indicates the possible number of NMR peaks. So let us start with a small example, N-propane. So what are the different types of protons present in the N-propane? You can observe the methyl protons at the terminals indicated by letter A are equivalent, and methylene protons at center is another type of nuclei and indicated by letter B. The total number of NMR signals, hence it will be 2. Let us take another example. Here all methyl protons are not equivalent. The methyl protons which are indicated by letter A are attached to CH, and methyl protons indicated by D are attached to CH2, so which are not equivalent. Similarly, another non-equivalent nuclei present in this molecule are methine protons indicated by P and methylene protons indicated by C. So the total number of NMR signals possible for the structure is 4. Now let us take an aromatic compound, nitrobenzene. Here, three types of protons are present. The protons indicated by A are ortho to nitro group, and the protons indicated by B are meta to nitro group, and the protons indicated by letter C are para to nitro group. So the total number of NMR signals possible is 3. Now let us go for an alkyl benzene, simple alkyl benzene. Let us take toluene. Here, the protons presented ortho, meta and para are actually magnetically non-equivalent, but their chemical shifts are similar, hence practically observed as single peak. And another proton indicated by B, which is also called as benzylic proton, is going to give another NMR signal. Therefore, the total number of NMR signals possible is 2. Now let us take a cyclic compound, 1-chloro cyclopentane. Here the protons above and below the plane are not equivalent. The protons indicated by A are above the plane and ortho to chlorine, and protons indicated by B are below the plane and ortho to chlorine. Similarly, the protons indicated by C are above the plane and meta to chlorine, and protons indicated by D are below the plane and meta to chlorine. Finally, the proton indicated by letter E is adjacent to chlorine and attached to the same carbon as chlorine. Hence, the total number of NMR signal possible is 5. Now let us take an unsaturated compound showing the geometrical isomerism. Here the proton indicated by A is trans to chlorine, and the proton indicated by A prime is cis to chlorine. Here A and A prime are used because they are having a very less difference in their chemical shifts. And these type of protons, which are chemically equivalent but magnetically not equivalent, are called as diastereotropic protons. Always remember, diastereotropic protons will give different NMR signals. Now the proton indicated by B is adjacent to chlorine and attached to the same carbon and will give another NMR signal. So the total number of NMR signals possible is 3. Thank you for watching, and keep watching the Wingate series of video tutorials.